Pandam Mukherjee and friends at the Dais. And I would like to first thank the Grace and CGR for inviting and me for this function, because when I saw the card and my friends, they told me that this is the Eastern Ghats. Because Eastern Ghats, Western Ghats, Himalayas, they are very important. Without these, the nation is, this India is not India, that is. And the Gangas. First of all, I would like to thank our chief guest who pioneered, and I became so emotional at that time when he was prime finance minister of this country. At that time, Dr. G.D. Agarwal, who turned a great scientist, who turned Swami, and he was on fast track to death. And I remember that he closed down four major mega dams in the Himalayas. And sir, so your action saved the Gangaji as well as at that time Dr. G.D. Agarwal. But later, the same Dr. G.D. Agarwal is no more now because of the inaction on the part of the government. He was a great scientist we have lost. And it was just one day on 11th October, his anniversary was the second anniversary, death anniversary here. So it is very shocking. But in history, we'll see that what the government did, how it had the courage to stop four dams at that time. And that cost about 600 crores. So that last, the government said that yes. So this is a wonderful action when the sensitive governments are there, they can really do something. But if the sensitivity is not there, whatever you want, there should be no difference in saying and doing. So if you say something, then you do something also. So these things are happening. But in short, my as far as the Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats are concerned, and the coastal zone, I have done all these cases and in the Supreme Court. And these are all ecologically sensitive areas, all most sensitive and vulnerable areas. And these need protection. We have the laws, but the laws are not being enforced. That is a tragedy in this country, that we make laws, but we make them only for breaking the law. We don't obey those laws. We don't do anything. And then just we say at every platform that yes, we have the law, we have all those things, we do everything, and nothing is unprotectable. I don't want to go further because I think that this audience is intelligent enough to know, understand what I'm trying to say. So this is what, so my study, why I'm saying about this study of Eastern Ghats, which has been conducted, this will be helpful to me in the court and at various courts, because it has been done by eminent persons, those who have the zeal to do that. So that is why, you know, I would be very happy to see that more and more people, they know what is this study, the Eastern Ghats, because I am doing the cases. Even now I'm doing the cases on these issues, and so I will try to see that this report is quoted in various at various forums. And so basically, my lords, the whole thing is that the things are going out of hand actually. So if we are not going to take steps, we are all going to be washed out. On the one hand, the Himalayas, and on the other hand, there are the coastal zones. So what are we going to do? So we are talking about the great nation, we are talking about so many things, and we are dreaming, so we are daydreamers actually, and it is not practical the things are happening which the nation should be proud of. And that is what my anxiety is, And I think that this the people, those who are here, the intellectuals, the scientists, the professors, and so many others, those who have a voice, they can raise the voice, and we should be able to sensitize the parliamentarians and the people, those who are in the authority. They should also understand that, yes, otherwise, if we are not going to protect the environment, then the day is not far off that it will create more disasters for the nation. Thank you very much.